Going on, guys, here with another vlog, here with a different video, because my last I was doing a video on my phone and my phone just died, so I'm on my mom's phone. This one is a bit good. It has better quality, it has waterproof, and it has a good screen protector, and my back camera and front camera work, so like you guys can see me, my face, and if I want to just flip my camera, so I just press the button and the camera just gets looked. Now, if you have seen this scene when I showed you this, you have probably seen this. I'm going to give you a mystery clue. There's one thing that powers the whole thing. It's the one thing that caused the problem to blink full time. I'll give you a third clue. It works the most, and it has an IC and a manual chip in it. What is it called? I'm gonna give you guys 5 seconds to find this out. Okay, I'll give you 10 seconds. And I'm done. Okay, so if you guess it, that's correct. If you guys guess this, be honest. Did you guys guess this? This might be it, guys. No, it's not. This is not broken. This is working absolutely fine. Next, we're gonna go to that. Is that working? Find out the drum roll. Is it working or not? It is working. Come down here. Is this working? It has a board in it. Ooh, I almost got you guys that mystery clue. Okay. Is this broken? Nope. This is not broken. It's functioning correctly as it should. Next, we go here. Is this broken? And it is not broken. I don't know why. This is technically broken, so I have my two speakers. And you guys are probably very confused what has been happening in these past 3-4 days. This TV got opened like 5 days or 3 days ago. But I'm not completely sure because I don't remember really good things. Okay, so let me just put this on. So now I have one question for you guys. Have you ever been on eBay? What is the most common thing that gets replaced with? And you just go ahead and you just buy this, but you're still looking for these. Now, this already is stuck onto your main board, but if you can't get it out, make sure to apply some heat to it so the adhesive that's around it, or the glue that they use, a little glue, is dissolved, so you can just whack it up. Now, the reason I have my mom's phone, because my phone died, it was a spin the windmill thingy as Apple things, and it just died. So now I am allowed to touch these, they won't current me, okay? But when I put in the power cord, I'll show you what's happening. Now, it doesn't blink 4 times anymore. It still doesn't work perfectly. The indicator doesn't turn green anymore. Something shorted out there, but that shorted out went to this main board. Then this main board doesn't even work. Now, this used to get hot. Now, it doesn't even get hot because that was getting voltage and it's getting checked. But this thing just like, oh, I'm going to get the hell out of here. And then it just disappeared. So now this is broken. This works. I know for a fact Ethernet port has never been used. And this has been used multiple times. And this has been used, all of this stuff here. And this whole main board is very, very important. If you find vertical line, oh, you're just going to go and buy a new whole TV. Make sure to buy a multimeter. Now, this multimeter is actually a pretty good multimeter. You can press the power button and then it tells you your volts. At the minute, it's going to tell me one because it's like an air. But I'm in 20 volts. This is volts and this is where it beeps. Now, I have my two cords in COM and I have it in volt. This means 10A and 10 volts for the other thing. For the car, this was for the car. This great fuses. And much more. So I'm gonna keep that in the side. Make sure it's on. If you don't have one, it's just okay. Just go and buy a cheap one, or just stick to watching this video, okay?
Now, some of you guys out there might have this little problem that your TV keeps blinking four times. First thing you want to do when you open your TV is unrelease this cord. After that, you're completely fine. You can open the back panel, but make sure to pay attention to the small detail by actually getting this really out. You don't want to just get the screw hanging there, because look, there's a fragmentation, and behind this is a backlight. So you don't want the backlight to be damaged. Now you can see here's the backlight. If I poke it, it's gonna get damaged, but not the most, because it's just a foam piece that surrounds it. Then it's the backlight. That's good. And the foams are there, so sort of it doesn't really get busted. So what you're gonna do with your cord is you're just gonna plug it in. Make sure you have an adult. I don't need an adult. I might not know about this, but okay. You just wanna plug it in, and you just wanna turn on the TV and just let it blink how it usually has a problem. So it blinks four times, right? And then it turns off. Good. That's everything going planned. Now you're gonna grab your multimeter, and you're just gonna come to this main supply thing here, and you're gonna just put your two leads like that, and you can see we're getting 14.25 volts. We're getting volts. I'll show you guys in a minute. Let me get my phone. There we go. You can see the voltage rising. It's going 13.93, 14.5. That's good. It means my voltage is going correctly. Now we're just gonna look at this thing. So we put on this detect, and we put on our other one. So it's 43 volts. Okay, that's 43 volts. Oh. Okay. Make sure you don't really touch these ones, because they're actually currented. So you can really touch two of these. Okay, this is good. I already know this works. I do have 42 voltage installed in this. Volts. That's absolutely fine. Now, the chip used to get hot. It does not get hot. Now, it could be this cord. But this cord is actually good, because look, it's working. And if I pull it out from here, my camera can detect this. So this, if you see this, you don't need to pull this top thing out. You need to actually pull the wire, the original wire. So you want to pull it just like that. Make sure you hear that slip. And you just want to get your multimeter, and maybe you might get voltage or something. I don't know, but get your negative lead and your positive lead. Make sure they're working when you get it. So put your positive lead right on a bare metal surface. So just like that, the screw. You maybe can get a screw if you rip, and I don't really, but I don't. Next, what you're gonna do is you're gonna check. Like, it does have volts, 42. It does have volts. So that's a quick tip that you guys can use by just checking the voltage. Next, I'm gonna take this, because I don't want to just read the voltage more and more. So now we're gonna go to our Ethernet port, and maybe just put some of there, and then maybe your Ethernet port is not working, so maybe you can check the voltage. If it's below 23, you have to replace it, but oh my god. Now I can probably wreck this mango, but I don't want to, because I'm gonna keep it. But the thing is that this CPU down here does work. So you can see it's getting voltage. 19 volts, that's good. But this one right here, it just, look, before when it was working, right, it only goes up to 17, 20 volts, and it stays, and then eventually, if my thing, when I turn on the TV, it was before dropping, now I don't know what's going on. Maybe it's not the main board. What is the problem? What the? How is this getting voltage? What the? Look, it says 11 volts. Now it's supposed to go high. I know why. It shakes. But if I really place attention and I touch these two leads, it drops. Like, it's on. So with my multimeter, you can just check anything you want. After you've done that, maybe just get some of you like, be a bit cheap. Make sure you go like that. Now I have been sparked like 3, 4, 6 times. So now I'm just putting the multimeter back. Put the multimeter. Now I don't understand how this is working. Now what actually happens is, I put in the multimeter, so I'm going to put the back on. Put it back on, I don't know why I'm going to turn it up. So, how much is this video getting up to now? Oh guys, I'm going to end the video. Bye bye!